afternoon. How is your day going? So the film industry is based on the ability to work with talented artists and the ability of studios to bring audiences. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to tell you about some of the work that we've done with the Google Cloud to marry stories and audiences. So we've seen for some time now that it's getting more expensive to bring customers and to attract talent. As an industry, we are moving from the bottom left to the upper right quadrant, and this move is building up tension between tectonic plates. On the one hand, the inertial forces embedded in the old ways of doing things. On the other hand, the what I'm calling AI-enabled capabilities. Audience discovery provides crucial information to executives and filmmakers, especially and critically for films that are non-sequels. Now, audience discovery is intimately related to the process of storytelling. When making a movie, filmmakers and a studio executive, they need to know and articulate why does the movie need to be made, what is new about the movie, and also who is this movie being made for. These questions are hard to answer precisely. And here's the key insight. The story and the audience are not set on stone. The alignment between the story and the audience doesn't just occur, it's the outcome of a process. Studios and filmmakers have actually many knobs that they can adjust to achieve this alignment. It's a complex problem, and it's a problem that benefits from data-driven insights, which is why studios have been busy collecting data and building tools. So today I'm going to tell you about two of the tools that we've built at Fox. The first one is called Marilyn. And Marilyn answers the question of what type of movie are we trying to make? Marilyn looks at a bunch of data. It looks at the trailer of the movie through computer vision. It looks at the plot of the movie through NLP. And then it outputs a report that describes the likely DNA of the movie based on the data. The second tool that we've built is called Nightcrawler. And it basically answers the question of, is this the movie that we were trying to make? And to answer the question, the tool does massive parallel multitest, sampling hundreds of different audiences, and it outputs a sophisticated report that helps us describe with unprecedented level of detail who are the core fans for this movie, who are the persuadable audiences, and who are the no-shows. So now I'm going to tell you about The Greatest Showman, because this was the first movie in which we actually applied the data. So on paper, this movie was set to be bringing similar audiences to the movie La La Land, which was another musical that opened the previous year. Our initial reads of online chatter in social media were in fact pointing in the direction of young female demos, which was consistent with the hypothesis of La La Land. The surprise came when we started to use the tool. When we analyzed the trailer, we discovered a broader audience that wasn't necessarily centered on younger demos. It was centered on family movies. It was centered on Disney musicals and feel-good empowerment dramas. This was very important because it suggested changes in our marketing strategy, changes that we think ended up having a big impact on the success of the movie. So fortunately for us, the movie did pretty well, grossing north of $400 million worldwide. So studios are learning to learn. They are learning to compete for stories and audiences in a world of incomplete but multidimensional data. And they are also putting in place the processes to measure the alignment between stories and audiences, which is going to be key for rapid reallocation. Finally, they are building AI-powered tools, not to dilute, but to amplify the work of talented, bright filmmakers, and to produce more relevant and urgent movie experiences. Thank you very much.